For the first time, we are hearing from officers as well as the 911 calls from inside the Aurora plant where a man opened fire as he was being terminated.
WGN's Tanya Francisco is here with that. Tanya?
Yeah, the Aurora Police Department released those audio tapes today on their Facebook page. The audio from the officers inside the plant is about an hour. There's another nearly 10 minutes of 911 calls from inside the plant. They were also released. Now, while it's riveting to listen as the first officers arrive on the scene, up until the gunman Gary Martin is taken down, we want to warn you, it may be disturbing to some.
We've got an active shooter, 641 Archer, 641 Archer Avenue.
The first of several 911 calls from employees inside Henry Pratt were the first sources of information.
An employee that's getting terminated. His name is Jerry Martin.
Minutes later, the first Aurora police officers to arrive on the scene confirmed the worst case scenario.
We do not have an eye sight on him. We do not have a sight on him.
No sight on the man.
Get the shields out. Get the shields out.
I got four victims upstairs in the one room. Three appear to be deceased.
Four victims upstairs. 10-4.
Oh, by the, there's another one in a bag. Just in the north. He's not moving.
The officers appear to be out of breath as they make their way through the building.
We got multiple shots fired. Multiple shots fired.
Doc 14, by 14, by 14.
Johnson, you just said it.
It's the door that says Pratt. That's where he's shooting out of. It's the broken glass window.
What floor is it on, the second or the first?
First floor.
What end of the building? I've been shot.
Within minutes, the first officer is shot.
Five, I'm with him.
Okay, are you shot?
Negative. Stairwell. North side.
A total of five officers would end up being hit during the incident. Today, the Aurora Police Department identified them as Adam Miller, Marco Gomez, John Sobolski, James Zagar, Reynaldo Rivera, and Diego Avila. A call would go out for assistance from other nearby police departments as the search continued.
He was over where I'm at. That's why I need to get out of here. I've got windows all around me. I need to move, but I can't. I have no protection, no shield. If you could bring that Bearcat over, I'm pleading with you. I've got a civilian out here.
A Bearcat eventually breached that door, followed by several teams of officers, all trying to locate the shooter, Gary Martin, while protecting more than 20 employees inside.
All right, my guy says here he did empty his gun, but then he was reloaded, possibly a lot of ammo.
Did you see him reloading?
Yes, my guy here that was standing there saw him reloading.
Confirming only pistol?
That's what he says, sole individual, only a pistol.
About 55 minutes into the search, flashbang grenades were deployed, and then this.
Contact me, we're moving forward. We got visual. Suspect appears to be down.
Suspect's down.
Now, Aurora police say the decision to release this audio was not made carelessly, but as a matter of public interest and their commitment to transparency, they added they felt the community had a right to hear the courageous souls who helped bring their horrible tragedy to a swift conclusion. We'll have more on those audio tapes coming up at 6 o'clock.
Thank you, Tanya. We'll see you then.